You're listening to the omnibus of
Ask the Monk.
Garen Fear, foolish mortals, but it's I, the Murloc, I've returned. Ah.
Hello, I am Murloc Cousin Soviet Murloc. I come from the Winterspring Country.
What are you doing here? What the hell, you blithering peasant? What are you doing in my mansion?
Hello, cousin. Grandmother sends regards.
With grandmother? I haven't spoken to her in 10 years. What does she do? What? Get out of my house, you blithering idiot.
You never sent Christmas card, so she sent me here.
Of course I don't send Christmas card. I hate her with a fiery passion and wish a horrible death upon her.
He's very rude. In old country, grandmother is respected.
Yes, but what have you got in your hand there?
His care package.
Care package? What? Care package? There seems to be a note in here. Dear Murloc, you must take care of your cousin, or I will kill you horribly.
Yes, grandmother is like that, to a point.
Oh, no, a blithering fool has got a debt again. Okay, fine, you can stay, but you'll have to help me with a feature.
Very well.
Okay, right. What we basically do here is we find blithering idiots such as yourself, and we read things, and then we insult them.
I can read. Read is good. Idiot not good. No one is idiot. You are idiot.
Look, stop it right now. I will not accept that kind of foolery in my house.
Very well, I go for a bar.
I see. Well, Chromagus. There is an idiot on Chromagus. We should really get his query, if you can call it that, read out.
Hello, Foreign Raven. He say, what is MC? I hear lot of things about MC. Know nothing about it still. Could you give me some info? What is word? Plus?
That would be plus. It's the peasant language for stupid.
Okay, plus. Sorry for stupid question. It's no stupid question. All question is good.
No, it is a stupid question. What the hell are you talking about?
Well, I don't know what MC is. What is MC?
MC? Who doesn't know what MC is? MC is... What is MC exactly?
To me, MC is person who scratches decks. And no way, that is DJ. MC is man who sells into mic. He talk into microphone very fast. And he say silly things about slapping women and about disrespecting your parents and driving fast bling bling.
Well, quite frankly, that sounds like the activity of the proletariat. You're not the proletariat, are you?
No, I am Cousin Soviet Murloc.
Is sure?
Yes.
Are you absolutely sure that you're not the proletariat?
No, I'm sure I am Soviet Murloc.
Okay, because I'm telling you I have absolutely...
I look now and check.
No time for that.
Where is my label?
Look, stop talking over me, you blithering peasant. I tell you, if you're not bourgeois or upwards, I will not accept you in this place.
I have caviar.
Ah, good call. MC is irrelevant. We do not care about your silly queries, you blithering peasant. Yes.
What silly question. Now you know answer.
Look, you're supposed to stop when I say, ha ha. Okay. And then we sort of introduce this kind of sample thing that says, ask the Murloc.
Okay.
Ha ha.
Ask the Murloc.
Sound was good.
No, it wasn't good. It was a manifestation of pure evil incarnate on this earth.
Exactly. Sound good.
Oh, God, this is not going to work. We're going to have to arrange something else.
No, grandmother kill you. Let her say. You remember, you read good. Cousin Murloc always read good.
Well, good lord. Oh, it's a nightmare. It brought upon us a penance for my sins.
Possible.
Yeah.
Next question?
Yes, okay. What does NERFT mean?
Hang on. This from man called Labish.
No one cares what the name of the insignificant whelp is.
No, name is good. Realm is Burning Legion. Sound hot. Hot is good. In old country is cold. We no have money for heating. Hot bath is rarity. I like Cousin Murloc's house. Has servant for hot bath.
Oh, stop exploiting my riches, you blithering fool.
Central heating good.
Question. Earn your keep, dammit.
He say, what is word nerfed meaning? Question is, Hopefully this is nice quick question. Oh, thank you. I sometimes see this in forums. E.G. What is E.G.? Egg.
Egg. Yes.
Egg. Oh, egg. Okay. That instance is nerfed.
So,
many thanks. Yes. He have no question. It's no question.
That is not a question.
Why is question?
There's no question mark after it. And what's this talk of eggs?
Egg.
Egg. That egg. Instant has been nerfed. The way it's written, it's kind of like there's a character called Egg in some kind of story, only there's no ending.
Egg is tasty. Maybe we eat egg. Egg would be good to eat. Maybe with some vegetables and some fish.
Or perhaps I'd just kill you with it.
How you kill someone with egg? Egg smash?
No, you maybe
make someone's head dirty and smelly.
No, look, be quiet, you blithering idiot. No, I shall be destroying you with an egg momentarily. However, you must earn your keep and answer the question.
Well, nerfed. Nerfed means something bad, I think. Egg, that instance has been nerfed, is probably mean that before instance was proper upstanding member of society, and now instance has done bad thing, so instance is relegated to penal colony. Somewhere. In far-flung corner of Azeroth.
Penal colony? That's the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard you spout out of your sorry excuse for an orifice.
It's not orifice, it's mouth.
No, it's orifice. It's an orifice and a mouth.
Is both?
Look, your grasp of English is pathetic. Now stop trying to lecture me.
I know lecture. You were smarter than me. You went to school. I worked fields. Hard fields. 6 hours a day. I provide your education.
You didn't provide, but... anyway, I think we should stop there because we've run out of time. Yes.
It's time for good sample again.
Good sample, yes.
Good sample. I like sample. Sample is good. But bath. It's time for bath, I think.
Yeah.
Servant!
I think perhaps you should do the laugh this time. Get some practice in.
Glug, 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 glug.
Oh, you are terrible. Absolutely pathetic. Aha!
Ask the Merlock. Last time on Ask the Merlock.
Hello. I am Merlock Cousin Soviet Merlock.
But, mother, I haven't spoken to her in 10 years. Take care of your cousin, or I will kill you horribly. Oh, no.
No one is idiot. You are idiot.
And now, the continuation.
Cousin, I have question.
Question? Oh, good God, dear boy. Why are you back here? What are you doing here?
Well, I live here, you remember. We had started, say, last time on Ask Merlock, blah, blah, blah.
What, last time? What have you been tampering with my tapes again?
No, I did find tape, though. Tape was very strange. Have very funny title, so I not watch. It's a hardcore Merlock on Merlock.
You see that's a private tape. You shouldn't go anywhere near it. His grandma's wedding. Yeah, very cheery. You know, very dull. You wouldn't be interested in.
Oh, grandmother's wedding! I sent tape to grandma.
No, you shall not do anything of the sort. No, that would be unacceptable. Besides, you know, she gave it to me for safekeeping. She was embarrassed about the whole affair. Yes, you don't need to see that.
Okay. Well, I have question. If question is all right. This place to ask question, is it not? Ask Merlock?
Okay, if you ask the question, will you be quiet and leave me alone?
Maybe.
Okay, I'll take the risk. On you go, ask your silly question.
Well, I sit in bath. Hot, nice, lovely bath. Make my skin all shiny and oozy with Merlock goodness. In old country, we not have heat. Merlock is dry and rugged. Here, Merlock is soft. Like silk.
Will you put your Soviet tangent away for 1 second and actually talk? Talk sense?
Well, God. I sit in bath and I think to self, where does sound come from?
Well, that basic physics, old boys. You see, sound is a reverberation of waves in the air, and it actually creates a sound wave, comes to your ears, and your brain interprets it, and that's how it works. I mean, I don't know if we had sound back in the old Soviet country, but, well, you see, over here, in the modern age, where entertainment is bland and inoffensive, then that is exactly where sound comes from.
Not sound. Sound. Ask Merlock sound. Where Ask Merlock sound come from? Log, log, log.
See, that is one of the forbidden questions that you should never, ever ask. Like, where did the universe come from, Daddy? Where did I come from, Daddy? Where does the Esther Murlock sound come from, Daddy? You shall not ask that question!
But sound come from somewhere. Where does sound come from? Who makes sound? Why sound come? And who pay for sound? Sound must be expensive if come from everywhere.
Okay, right, let's just play along for a second, okay? So, we say the sound, as the Murlock, comes from somewhere. Then surely it would have to respond to something.
Yes, question.
So, if you were to ask a question, you would hear, as the Murlock.
Okay, we try. How much is 5 plus 10?
I can't hear a sound. I think you've done it wrong, you jabbering fool.
All right, we try other question. Quick, bring other question. We try random question from silly people on the forum. Okay.
Yeah.
Someone say, no know who, he no leave name. I just get game recently, and brother of my, family ties, so nice. Would like
family
to start
tie
game.
Around your neck.
Shush. Would like to start game, so we play together. I know, cannot we use same account? Yes, using same account at same time is not possible. But can we use copy of the game that I have to have two account with same authentication key?
Please, please, stop mangling the English language in your sorry excuse for a mouth. It says authentication key, or will we need a second copy of the game?
Thanks. What is this? It have funny...
Colon bracket.
Colon bracket. What colon bracket mean?
It's some kind of stupid language for stupid.
If you look on side, it look like smiley face.
No, that can't be possible. You're just interpreting it in completely wrong way, you silly peasant.
Oh, okay. He's wrong. Well, if you have one copy of game, can you have two account?
Absolutely not! What kind of a gibbering, jabbering, blithering, blathering, complete, stupendous imbecile would think that? I cannot fathom the stupidity of youth these days. I blame pop music and hippity-hop.
Well, we ask questions, so we listen for sound now?
Oh, you idiot, we don't get the sound until I go, naha!
Ask the Murlock.
I think sound come from over there. We must follow quick.
Yeah, well, you see, I don't have any legs. You know, it's very, very big inconvenience, but no, you can go over there. That'll be absolutely fine. Go on.
All right, you stay here. I go find sound.
Okay.
I know find sound.
You're back already. I was just starting to get comfortable.
I could not find sound. Sound was nowhere. There was wall. Wall in the way. And I so slimy from bath, I cannot break through wall.
You can break through walls?
Yes. In old country, we have to break through wall, because there no door.
Yeah, I cannot imagine living in a mud-slewed slime pit of a country you call a country.
It's not really country, it's more like province.
I see. So, the sound comes with the question, so, well, we better ask another question, then we can send you off far, far away in search of the sound.
Well, we go to wall, let us go to wall, and then we ask question at wall, and maybe we hear more accurately where sound come from.
Okay, we go to the wall. You'll have to carry me, though, remember, I have no legs.
Quick, bring parchment with question on.
I see, parchment.
Question, what is question?
Open question. Okay, question. Yes. Okay, my dad won't let me play WoW because he says it is no good for me, but I think WoW is really fun. Is this in your language?
No, there is no word, Raleigh. Raleigh? In my language.
Oh, Raleigh?
Oh, Raleigh. Oh, yeah, Raleigh.
Oh, I see. Right. And then I say my dad is stupid, but then he gets more angry and say I never can play WoW again. If I say he is stupid, I hate him so much because he is Raleigh stupid.
Raleigh? Yeah, Raleigh.
Oh, really?
Please, no, that is not the same question.
No,
that is
you're
question.
An idiot.
That is not question. Where is question mark? I see lot of exclamation mark. Pointy line is wrong. No question.
Nah.
We listen for sound, though?
We haven't answered the question yet. Surely it won't work. Well, my answer to that question is kill your father with an ice pick.
With ice pick?
Yes.
Surely with maybe gun is better.
No, 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 no. You don't seem to get it. This is not your scum-filled country of the common soldiery. This is an established and very civilized nation. We kill people with ice picks because it metaphorically represents his heart of ice.
How about Frostbolt? Frostbolt
no,
is
no,
cold.
No, no, no. Magic is unacceptable. Magic is witchcraft. No, 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 no magic, no.
Oh, okay. Well, if you must kill father, kill him cleanly and hide corpse somewhere no one look. Otherwise, you get in a lot of trouble.
Ta-ha!
Ask the Murloc.
I know fine sound.
Oh, what a shame. Keep looking, though. I'm sure you'll find it sometime.
Ask more questions.
No, there's no time for any more questions.
Yes, more questions.
No.
You must find sound.
Oh, God.
Tape to grandmother.
No, no, you can't do that. Ta ha!
Ask the Murloc. Last time on Ask the Murloc.
Cousin, I have question.
On you go, ask your silly question.
This place to ask question, is it not? Ask Murloc. Where does sound come from?
You shall not ask that question.
I think sound come from over there. We must follow quick. I know fine sound. There was wall.
You can break through walls?
Yes. In old country, we have to break through wall, cause there no door.
And now, the continuation.
Cousin, you remember you say you come find sound with me? I have good idea for what we do to find sound.
No, generally speaking, you've never had a good idea in your paltry existence upon the planet, so it's very, very unlikely that it's going to start now.
Well, I read in newspaper, Times of Azeroth, that there is other thing that we can find as well as sound. It's called Cup of Moonsilver.
The Cup of Moonsilver? How incredibly worth it. Oh, you say silver?
Yes, silver. It sells for many, many golds, funny enough. And with silver we make new wall for walls I break, cause they're door lacking.
You want to make a wall entirely out of silver?
Yes.
I see. Well, quite frankly... So you said gold?
Yes, gold.
Gold.
Silver sell for many golds. It's strange. Economy not work properly here.
Yes.
Normally we sell potato for gold.
But we can sell silver, a quite less precious metal, for many gold. Did you even think this through before writing down your pifflingly stupid idea?
No, I just read in paper and I come running.
I see. Well. It's...
Well... We go and we make quest, epic quest. All the quest is epic. In old country, we hear many songs about epic quest. Always it stir, and it make you warm in freezing nights when heating not work.
I tell you what would make you warm in freezing nights, you... Yeah, it's not even worth going there, because it's not actually funny. Continue.
Yes, well, we go and we find Cup of Moon Silver. Not be confused with Chalice of Silver Moon. It's a completely different thing.
Sorry, what did you say again there?
The Chalice of Silver Moon.
I say...
The Chalice of Silver Moon.
And then, when we find Cup of Moon Silver, maybe we find sound as well. Maybe Cup of Moon Silver is causing sound. Is this cup shape? Maybe someone yelling to cup shape and it broadcasts sound everywhere. And also, you can meet people along the way who ask the question.
Oh, yeah.
It's
sure
good chance, good chance to meet people and say hello and say thank you for question. Question was good. We are here. We can answer more question. Have you more question?
But you don't seem to understand. Why would I want to do that? I hate these people with a fiery passion.
No, it's not true. You love them, really.
No, I don't. Oh, God, you are so incredibly disgustingly pleasant.
Well, if it help, I sure they pay money for question. Is how we fund Epic Quest, with money for question. And maybe we can kill thing along the way, like Big Dragon. I hear Big Dragon is good for money.
But you want to kill a Big Dragon? Look at you, you're about 4 foot tall. You probably couldn't even wield a giant stick, let alone any kind of armament of any kind. And I don't have any legs. What the hell are we supposed to do against the dragon?
I can break through wall. I'm pretty sure I could break through dragon as well. Hello, dragon, bang, into dragon, rah, rip dragon to pieces. Ooh, dragon have gold inside. There we go, sell gold.
You have a very strange way of looking at the world, dear boy.
It's basic economics.
Well, God.
Kill dragon, dragon make gold, gold make house, house make wall, Murloc break wall, Murloc find dragon.
So, what you're basically saying to me is, you want to go on an epic quest, which may or may not last many, many episodes, and find this mysterious cup of moon silver, and possibly a dragon that can be broken through, and inside its innards are an absolutely large pile of gold.
And sound.
And sound.
We find sound. Sound is ultimate goal. Everything else is bonus.
You do realize that if anyone were to broadcast, say, a radio play of this ridiculous incident, it would be absolutely the worst storyline ever written in mankind.
We keep it hush-hush, yes?
Okay.
Top secret. Nobody will know.
Fine, okay. You've convinced me. However, I believe there are a few things we need to do before we go. We'll have to tie a few loose ends. I've still got to answer questions this week.
Well, okay. First off, we answer question, and then sound come, and we make compass and map, and then we draw on map where do we go for sound. It's simple.
I see. Okay, right. Well, let's find the first question. Right, question. Silly, pointless, piffling question.
Question is good. Question will help us find way for finding sound. So our question is from man with beard and mustache, is blonde, is 6th level. His name is Dervast from Realm Ionar. And he say, how to use diagonal line prey?
I want to know, where do we use them?
There what, is arrow there.
Arrow? Pointing arrow. To a question mark. Perhaps it's emphasis.
Emphasized question?
Indeed. Emphasized question. I have found many players laying down or praying.
Okay, I can answer this one. When you use prey is when great event happens, like you break through wall last night to get in house, and then in morning wall is fixed, or all of a sudden harvest is very good when land was very bad, or giant dead sea monster it turn up unexpectedly in middle of field, and then we praise Cthulhu.
What? You praise Cthulhu? You don't seriously believe that Cthulhu actually fixed that wall? You broke through and destroyed him in a whole mess of my house. You know how much cleaners I had to bring in overtime? Time and a half I have to pay these people.
No, it's all Cthulhu. Cthulhu, he tell me in dream, he fixed the wall. He says, Soviet, you are a good worshipper. I fixed the wall and all is good, and cousin will never know difference of all other 50 walls you break.
What?
Especially supporting walls. Especially supporting walls. House almost fall down. But then Cthulhu, he fix it. And for that, we worship him. We will not worship other lesser deities, like Captain Blamange.
Oh, God. It's such a mixed bag of hate I have for you right now. I hate you, I pity you, and now, quite frankly, I'm a little bit scared.
Well, we go to my shrine to Cthulhu, where I have big squid head in jar of formaldehyde. And then we lay offering to Cthulhu. And maybe Cthulhu help us on quest to find sound. Could happen. So that is when you use the prey command.
Right, okay. So we're going on the quest. Well, what do we need to take with us?
We need to take portable shrine to Cthulhu. And we need to take compass and map. And we need to take pen to write on map. And to do doodles on side.
And how do you propose that I actually get anywhere without any legs?
We make some sort of flying machine, and flying machine carry you.
Do you think I, the great Murloc, would ever trust you with making such a complex contraption? This would, quite frankly, more than likely crash into the ground and get us all killed in a large burning flame when you can't even use a door properly.
No, we don't use big flying contraption. Just flying contraption is small flying, like Professor X in wheelchair.
Oh, God, I'm going to die.
Ha!
Last time on Ask the Murloc.
And so, our heroes did embark for differing reasons. One to follow his heart, and one to follow his wallet. They did go on a long and episodic quest to discover the source of the mysterious sound, and to find a silver cup to replace the damaged walls. We join our heroes in the midst of preparations to set out on their journey.
Hell are you doing, you incompetent excuse for a moron?
I make plan. Plan for journey. Journey need plan, or we die horrible, cold, and starving on side of road.
Maybe somebody come and carve us up and make shish kebab of us.
Oh, I don't believe you still want to go with this futile excuse for a quest. I thought it was just one of these things that you young children do these days. You go up on one of these little fads and like, ooh, this week's cool MTV fad involves us going on an epic quest looking for some stupid cup which probably doesn't exist to replace the walls you damaged earlier.
No, no, we look for sound. You remember, we find the sound. Cup of Moonsilver is little side project. It's fun. Fun bonus. If we find Cup of Moonsilver, we'd be very, very rich and can pay for people to kick themselves in backside. But normally, we'd be searching for sound. Sound is ultimate goal.
Well, why are we even searching for the sound in the first place? What kind of possible profit could we make from this little adventure?
If you know where sound comes from, you can have sound at special events. You have, like, big music festival, and you just say, Ask Murloc, blag, 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 blag.
So, what you're basically suggesting is we earn royalties.
Yes.
I see. Wow.
Or could terrorize people with sound.
Oh, you see, now I like the way you think, dear boy. Yes.
We make sound unless you pay us a lot of gold.
Indeed.
Speak of which, we need buy supplies.
Yes, we do. That's true. Okay, well, you've got your plans there. Let's see your plans. Come on. Let's see the plans.
Plan says we need following things. He says we need food. Says we need the flying machine for you, who's no legs. And we need the food again. And the vodka. Always the vodka. Keep you warm on the cold nights. And plan says we need the spare change of underpants.
Why would we need the spare change of underpants, exactly?
Because you cannot wear the same underpants all the time. It's disgusting and filthy and dirty. You need spare pairs so you can wash first pair, so you can wear the spare pair whilst you wash first pair. I'm confused now.
You wear underpants?
Yes. It's cold in old country. In old country, it's too cold. If you not wear underpants, all your danglies fall off.
You're a foreign little wimp, you know that.
Well, you is Southern Fairy.
Yeah, stiff upper lip, dear boy.
No, no, no.
Anyway.
Yes, let us go to shop. We have lot of things here. Now we have all the things we need for the journey. Let us go and pay at the counter.
Well, you see, that could be a little bit of a problem.
Why? You don't have money. I bring you because you have the money. You have the big house. Where is the money?
It's tied up in offshore accounts, premium bonds, and in sort of investment overtures, and spigling dog wallogs, and all that kind of thing. It's very complicated financial stuff. You wouldn't possibly understand it.
What does that mean? That mean you have no money?
Yes.
Good Lord in heaven, you have no money! Why I even bring you have no money? I could find cup of Moonsilver and sound my own. But I bring you because you're my cousin, and you're supposed to look after me because I'm quite simple. And you have no money! This is disgraceful! We must beg for the money now.
No, you will be doing the begging, dear boy, because quite frankly, I think you're probably used to it coming from your sorry excuse for a nation.
No, I never beg. We always work. We have trouble to make end meet, but we never beg. Anyway, you should beg because you have no leg. Where'd that sound come from? We have Ask Murloc sound, and now we have Diddle-Little-Little-Little. We must find out where all these sounds come from.
No, we mustn't. Hello? Hello? Arms for the rich. Arms for the rich and wealthy. We're going on a quest. Yes, help sick children and there's many puppies involved and yes, money. Give me lots of money.
I say, a begging Murloc. How do, sir?
I am not a begging Murloc, sir. I am the Murloc. Ha ha.
Well, you appear to be begging, and you're asking for money and everything. You have no legs, there's a begging bowl by you. You look to be a beggar to me. All you're missing is the affectionate give gold, please.
That is not a bowl, good sir. It is a hat. I've taken it off because it is exceedingly warm day. Now, thou shalt not mock me in thy pathetically withering way.
Well, get on with it then. Make your pitch. I'm a busy man. I have epics to get. Dragons to farm.
Okay, fine. If you want something, I am the Oracle of Ages. I will answer any of your questions. And all you need to do is give me gold, please.
Okay, then. My question is, hello. I was wondering if someone knows anything about some health disappearing thing. Because when I was playing Y Day, I logged in and had 352 HP, comma. 10 minutes later, I had 252. Is this normal?
Well, sir, as the Oracle of Ages, I can answer your question in the most amazing fashion imaginable, Gif Goldblix. You must, in fact, be dying of an incurable disease. That is the only explanation for your lack of hit points, you sniveling worm.
My goodness, how did you know?
It was just a feeling I had. My Murloc sense is tingling.
I thought only Spider-Man had a sense like that.
No, Spider-Man doesn't exist, along with the Tooth Fairy and Jesus and all that kind of thing.
Very well. Here, a gold for your troubles.
I'm afraid I will require a little bit more from you, sir.
What do you mean? I just gave you a gold. You asked Goldblix, I give you gold.
I will require your legs.
My legs? Whatever are you talking about?
I need your legs, sir.
What possible use could you have for them? You're not a surgeon, you're a Murloc.
As you may have noticed, I don't have any legs. Therefore, taking your legs is the only logical conclusion.
Well, I suppose when you put it that way, it does sort of make sense. But still, you're no surgeon, as I just pointed out, you're the Murloc.
I don't care. I am an evil bastard.
Very well. It appears that we must fight to the death. But first, you must tell me. Where the devil did your legs go in the first place?
Sort of embarrassing story, really. Opioid addiction, had to be amputated, very unpleasant affair. However, your legs will be mine, sir.
Very well. We shall duel. Cousin, what are you doing? Why is man on the floor? Why is man neck in your mouth? Why is there blood everywhere? You kill man?
Not exactly. This man donated the money we require for our provisions.
Let's see what man got then. Let's see. Man have 13 gold. Man have 2 legs. Man have armor and weapon. We sell all. Sell all to vendor, including legs. Okay, now we have everything. We can go and start the quest. Hurrah!
Oh, hey then.
What is that, cousin? Why you have arms still in mouth? We vendor everything. All vendor right. Trash.
I know.
Well, when you go hungry later, I not share the food with you. Let us go.
Yes.
Ask the Murloc. Last time on Ask the Murloc.
And so it came to pass that our two questionable heroes set out on their seemingly never-ending and interestingly episodic journey to find the source of the sound and bag some fat loots upon the way. After slaying a traveler and selling his body parts to a nearby vendor for cash, our heroes had all they needed to start the episode. Except for one thing. Somebody had the map upside down.
It's not my fault! North is down!
Oh, you blithering idiot!
Cousin, look! North is down?
North is not down! How many times do I have to tell you this? I don't know what you've done, but does this really look like the nice town of wenches that you said we'd be at 3 hours ago?
Well, we'd be in town by nightfall, but look! You look on the map, and it say, we are here, town is here, north is down, we go north.
Are you sure you're reading that thing right?
Well, north is down, right?
No, north is not down, what the hell have you been doing, you blithering idiot? Oh god, you've got the map upside down.
North is up?
Yes, north is up, why wouldn't it be up?
Alright, we turn map round. We are here. Town is here. We've been going south. Oh, dear.
Oh, let me see that thing. So, we started here, and we ended up back here because of your blithering idiocy, and now we're in the forest of spidery death.
Sound nice?
No, it doesn't sound nice. Oh, I'm gonna die here. Possibly bears, lions, maybe some kind of evil, angry stag will impale me on its horns and I will rot, never feasting upon the flesh of the innocent.
It's not all bad. We get out of the forest and we find town and then we go and have drinks.
Oh, I need a cocktail. Huh, get me the bag. I want the bag with the provisions in it. Ah, yes. Delicious schnapps. I am going to sit down over here. You spouting excuse for an imbecile, are going to stand over there and watch out for nasty evil creatures attempting to eat me.
Cousin,
what are you doing interrupting my cocktail party solo fantasy?
Well, you said to warn you if there is a big fanged monstrosity come to eat you.
Yes, and your point?
The cousin, that there is spider behind you.
Why? Run away. I can't run away. I don't have any legs. What the hell are you doing?
I carry you all.
Spiders. Get it away. This was your fault.
I will carry all on my back. Run. Quick, into cave.
Into the cave. Come on, into the cave.
By fire be purged.
Out of the cave.
Run away.
Quick, let's head for that strange phallic-looking tower in the distance.
Yes, tower will be good to hide in, but we must run from horrible monsters.
Yes, you must run, and I must look panicked.
Having fled like a pair of sissy girls from the strange-looking spider of the oddly placed Ragnaros, our heroes arrived at the strange phallic tower.
Who live in tower like this?
Who live in tower like this?
I don't know, that's why I asked.
Oh, I see. Well, it looks rather swanky, you know, rather civilized place. I would strongly suggest that I do the talking while you sort of stay in the shadows looking sorry for yourself.
Okay, you can talk.
Indeed, okay. I suppose I better knock on the door. Where is the door? I cannot find the door.
There is no door.
Okay, well, don't you have some kind of special superpower related to this?
Well, I could break down the wall, but wall look quite tough. He's made of brick. Brick is hurting. Normally in old country we have mud huts.
Just get through the wall!
Okay. Give me 2 minutes. What the devil are you doing to my tower?
Are you the proprietor of this establishment?
Yes, I am the great Manaldo, Lord of the Arcanist. Check my Arcanist. It's full 8 out of 8 pieces. 15% reduction on threat. I thank you for your praise.
Well, it kind of looks like a dressing, yeah? But
I refute that. You're in my tower under my command. I am the great Manaldo.
Well, easy. We're not technically in your tower. We're sort of kind of trying to bash a hole in it. You know, it's quite different.
Technicalities. The great Manaldo has no need for technicalities. You may not pass. You shall not pass my tower, for I am the great Manaldo, and I dictate the laws of the forest.
Well, you see, we don't really need to pass the tower. It's sort of on a hill, out of the way.
No!
We can just leave.
You cannot pass the tower. See the line I drew in the ground? The line! You cannot pass the line, for the great Manaldo demands it!
Okay, well, since you seem to be rather angry and possibly quite twisted, I would ask you to name your demands, yes.
You must answer the great Manaldo's question if you want to pass.
You want me to answer the great Manaldo's question?
Several questions, in fact.
I suppose we don't have an option in this.
No, you do not, for I'm the great Manaldo, and I shall hit you with my pitiful pyroblast if you do not accede to my demands.
Okay. Please, the great Manaldo, continue with your questions.
My first question is, who do you work for, Murloc?
I am a sort of a kind of freelance at the moment. I was fired from my previous job at a...
Silence! The great Manaldo demands that you answer the second question.
And what exactly would that question be?
Hold on, I'll just bring it out from my robe. I wrote it down.
I see. Well, that was very clever of you.
The great Manaldo's question is, I have a friend who recently bought World of Warcraft and has got to the same level as me, and he wants to team with me, the great Manaldo, and I'm not sure if I should or not because, well, there are several reasons, but I want your opinion on this. Many thanks.
Why do you want my opinion on this? You have the great Manaldo.
Because you cannot cross the line until you answer the great Manaldo's question.
Oh, God. Okay, I will answer your question. But a simple answer to your question would be, it would not be advisable to group with your friend at all.
Why is that?
Because you can catch PTDs, party transmitted diseases. They're very unpleasant. They have warts in very awkward places. It's not very nice. And they do smell, and you start to excrete foul juices. It's, oh, horrible business. They're not very pleasant at all. I wouldn't recommend it. No, no, not at all.
Very well. You've answered the great manner of those questions. You may pass the line. But first, I require your presence for tea and biscuits.
Tea and biscuits? Oh, God, I have endured your ridiculous questions. I have endured your ridiculous...
Silence!
No, I will not be silent.
Silence!
No, I refuse to be silent. You, sir, will perish.
The great Manaldo will now pyroblast you for your insolence. Hadouken!
And so the Moloch did resist Manaldo's pyroblast, for the Arcanist set is really quite dire. After this, Manaldo's magical energies were spent, and so the Moloch did set about Manaldo with a large cudgel with nails in it, and did feast upon his entrails. The Soviet Moloch, during this time, had gone off to chase a butterfly, and returned to find a rather gore-splattered and, quite frankly, hilarious scene.
Cousin! 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 Why is that a mortar man in your mouth? This is not good. Not good. This is man's tower. Why you are eating the man with the tower? We not get into the tower now. We still no listen for the sound. We no know where we going. Did you even answer the question?
Yes, I answered the question, you blithering idiot. I'm afraid, however, our friend Manaldo has had to split.
Ask the Moloch.
Follow sound. We must get to town before it is darker.
Last time on Ask the Moloch.
And so, our heroes continue on their epic quest. They battle through the forest of spidery death, past the tower of the great Manaldo, onward towards the town of Wenches, which, according to the brochure, is full of nubile, busty young women, serving drinks in the finest beer halls of Azeroth. Unfortunately, whilst they were looking at the brochure, they took a wrong turn, towards the similar-looking town of Men, twinned with bears. We join our heroes as they arrive at their destination.
What is this? This sign says, "Hello, and welcome you very much to town of Men."
Town of men and bears?
Twinned with bears?
Twinned with bears! Men and bears!
Where is town of Wenches?
I don't understand what you... Oh, God, it's probably your fault again. Were you looking at the map the wrong side down? The wrong side down again?
No, I threw a map into river.
You threw a map into the river? Why did you do a ridiculous thing like that?
Because we have brochure and map, and you cannot carry two.
Well, yes, you can! What... Why would you do that?
It no matter. We get new map.
Oh.
Anyway, to the pub.
Okay, fine. I'm sure the sign is simply a typo's mistake made by a blithering peasant. That's fine. To the drinking establishment.
Hello, bald person. Where is Busty Woman? I need drink from Busty Woman.
Busty Woman? I have no need for your Busty Woman, for we have men and bears, and that is all that has mattered.
Okay, I have two beer then. And cousin, what do you drink?
I am drinking your soul.
No, really, what are you drinking?
No, really, it's a cocktail. It's called Your Soul. It's quite nice.
Two beer and your soul.
Coming right up.
Excuse me.
Yes?
Where is Wenches?
Wenches? We have no need of wenches here, for this be the town of men and bears.
Alright. Who is in charge of town of men? We need speak to him about missing wenches.
Oh, the town of men is in charge of the mayor of men. Yeah, you can speak to the mayor of men about any affairs in this place.
Where is mayor of men?
He's right over there in the corner.
Alright, we go speak to mayor of men, and thank you very much for drinks.
Oh, God, what are you doing now?
We got to speak to Mayor of Men. Maybe he know where missing busty wenches are.
Now, why on earth would we want to speak to that large, 7-foot, hulking, vest-wearing, hairy excuse for a man over there?
Maybe he have lot of money.
Perhaps you make a point. Okay, let's go and speak to the Mayor of Men. Good sir, excuse me. Down here, excuse me. I would like to speak to you. Perhaps take a moment of your time.
I am the Mayor of Men. What could you possibly want from me?
Well, you see, we sort of... Well, we were aiming for the town of Wenches. Do you know of it?
Yes, the town of Wenches is over the valley on the other side.
I see. Okay. Well, we'll be just taking our leave now, then.
Wait, you look like adventurers of some description. Maybe you could help me.
And just to ask a question, despite the fact that you are large and hairy, 7-foot hulking man that could quite possibly rip off my cousin's head, why exactly would anyone to help you?
Because there is a reward for it.
What kind of reward are you talking?
A substantial cash reward.
A substantial cash reward. Very, very inviting, sir. Do tell.
And also the possibility of the location of the fabled Cup of Moonsilver.
Hang on. How do you know that we are pursuing the Cup of Moonsilver?
I don't. It's just that the person you are supposed to rescue may know where it is.
So you just sort of brought it up in a kind of plot hole fashion?
Possibly.
I see. Well, do continue.
Yes. Well, as you know, the town of Men is twinned with bears. And obviously, we keep up a high level of relations with the town of Bears in Northrend. In fact, the Chancellor of Bears himself was here not so long ago, but he has been kidnapped by his arch-enemy, the Marquis de Saren.
So what you're basically telling me is that you maintain amicable relationship with bears. Large, dangerous, hairy bears that quite frankly would want to eat your intestines and hang them around in some kind of floral array.
But that's beside the point. We maintain relationship with the town of Bears, and the Chancellor of Bears has been kidnapped. Now this reflects very badly on the town of Men. So what I need to do, too, strapping chaps to do, is go and find the Marquis de Salmon and rescue the Chancellor of Bears.
And you're saying there's some kind of a cash reward for this?
A substantial cash reward.
A substantial
cash reward. The coffers of Men will be open to you.
Oh, you see, the coffers of Men. Well, that doesn't sound remotely sexual anyway. Okay, we shall go and find your lost Chancellor of Bears.
Very well. I shall give you a map to the Marquis de Salmon's mansion. Here, take it.
It's good. I take map. I read map good. Note this down.
I see. Against my better judgment, I am going to allow you to hold the map.
Hooray! We set out now to find the Chancellor of... Was it the Bears? Or maybe we finish drink first?
No, we must go now.
All right, I down drink very quickly then.
Go.
No class, that boy.
Yes. Let us be going now.
I think we need to leave by the door.
Okay.
No, not the wall, you gas-bladdering moron!
It's alright. It's the old country. We leave through the wall, cause there's no door.
Why, in that case, is there a mob of men pursuing us with torches and pitchforks?
It's no mob of men. He's one man.
Run away!
He's pub owner. He have
God, bill. Don't stand around.
It's fine. We pay bills and we get money for the Chancellor of Bears.
God, take me out of here right now.
Quick, we go. Maps say this way.
Several minutes later, they arrived at the evil, spooky mansion of the Marquis de Salmon, which had to be said was looming in the distance somewhere over to the left. The map was rather irrelevant, but it did fill in 30 seconds of the episode.
Look, we do this my way. We go, I go to Bell, and I press Bell, and I ask for Bears back.
You seriously believe that asking for the Chancellor of Bears, who has been kidnapped by the evil Marquis de Salmon in his evil, looming, 300-foot-tall Black Mansion of Death is actually going to work?
Yes, look, watch, I do this, look. Bzzz. Hello, I am looking for Chancellor of Bears. I need Chancellor of Bears. Will you please give back Chancellor of Bears so we can have a cup of moon silver and get on with finding sound?
No, the Marquis de Salmon will not acquiesce to your demands. We will not give up the Chancellor of Bears.
Acquiesce? What mean that?
It means they cannot have the Chancellor of Bears under any circumstances or plans that you may or may not formulate.
Oh, okay. Thank you for your time.
That is not a problem. Please visit my gloomy mansion again soon.
Cousin, we must plan very, very carefully to get Chancellor of Bears out of house. Maybe we take a week to plan? Yes? Week sounds good.
Oh, God, why do I feel like I'm going to be mauled and torn into 1,000 pieces by next week? Next time on
Ask the Moloch.
You seriously think we tell you what happened next week now? Even we don't know what happened next week.
Don't be ridiculous. You'll have to listen to next week's show. Otherwise, why would we even bother?
Yes. Tune in next week. Maybe we have planned. Maybe we know. Maybe we go back. Maybe we I don't know. Maybe we get bored. Very bored.
Maybe I club my cousin over the head with a large piece of pipe.
A grandmother will know. She have the psychic power.
Oh.
And so, last time we saw our heroes, they were stood rather helplessly outside the mansion of the cunning Marquis de Salmon, who had taken hostage the Chancellor of Bears from the town of Maine. Our heroes did bravely attempt to enter this foreboding place, but fell down a rather large plot hole and took 2 weeks to climb out of it. We join our heroes back where they started, standing outside the mansion, fresh out of ideas.
Right, you spouting excuse for an imbecile. You must know exactly what you are going to do in this situation.
What is that? What I do? It's been 2 weeks. I don't know what to do.
Oh,
I was
God.
A very long nap.
Your silly peon memory is failing the entire group. You realize you're letting the entire team down at this point?
He's a wipe?
It's a wipe, yes. Right.
Quick, grab the soul stone.
Look, the only reason I brought you on this trip in the first place is your ability to bash through solid objects. Now, look, that is a solid object. I expect you to bash through it now.
Okay, we bash through the wall. Look, here I go. Ow! The wall is shiny and the dust...
No, you wimp.
Dust.
Do it again. Do it again.
All right, I tell you in a minute. Ow! Wall dust is glowy. Well, it look radioactive.
Is it valuable?
No, it's dangerous.
Oh.
Maybe it's arcanite wall. Arcanite wall is radioactive. Yeah, I know this. In old country, we have arcanite plant. We have big arcanite plant. Oh, pride of country. And then one day, boom, it's blow up. Kill a lot of people, make fallout.
How exactly would you make a plant out of arcanite anyway? Should we giant arcanite tree? Daffodil? You crazy moron.
Convert the arcanite. You make the arcanite converter with the engineering, and then you convert the arcanite and you smoosh it together and you make the power with it.
Oh,
and you
God.
Power the I'm, whole nation.
I'm stuck outside a loomy, gloomy mansion. I need to rescue a Chancellor of Bears.
You be quiet now.
And
be quiet.
I am accompanied
I tell
by a
you
moron.
Situation. We have a radioactive wall. I cannot break through radioactive wall. We must find other way to get through wall.
Oh, God. I can't be bothered. Look at that. There's some kind of evil-looking creature over there. I am going to feast upon its flesh. Now, if you'll excuse me for one moment.
All right. You kill now. Your bloodlust is sated. What is on body? What loot? Fat loot he drop? What that?
Plan small C4ium charge.
Well, the C4ium charge is small thing that go boom. Maybe it could get through a wall, but none of us know engineering.
Well, I thought you'd constructed this giant flying machine.
No, we bought that from shop, remember?
Oh, yes, I did, yeah. So, plot holes aside, what exactly are we going to do in this situation?
Well, you go learn engineering, but...
I'm not going to learn engineering! That's the...
I was going to say...
...activity of peasants and
I
the
was
common
going to
soldiery.
Say, you could learn engineering, but you have no legs.
Indeed.
So I will go learn engineering, because he's pride of the country of Winterspring.
Pride of the country of imbeciles.
6 months later...
Look, cousin, I return with master's degree in goblin engineering from the University of Gadgetzan.
Oh, God, you're back already. I was just starting to get comfortable.
You're still here? Is Chancellor of Bears still in-house, you think?
Or... Probably. I honestly couldn't care less.
It would be convenient if he was still in-house. Otherwise, we waste entire 6 months making engineering courses.
Yes, but I was just finishing off this delicious cognac, and quite frankly, I did not require your interruptions.
Well, stand back. I bring the planned small Sephorium charge, which I learned now, and I also bring the materials for small Sephorium charge. Is the blasting powder and the water. Is a funny combination.
Maybe... blasting powder and water. You say you have an advanced diploma in, what is it, advanced goblin engineering, and you intend to make explosives out of water and dust.
Yes.
Oh, God. Well, can I just finish my cognac?
No. We will make the Sephorium charged now.
Quick, forward! Once more into the breach, dear cousin who I hate with a fiery passion.
No, we must plan. It's likely that Marquis de Salmon is crafty and cunning and have many guards around. We must sneak. So we must look for something to sneak around in so we not look like pair of Murloc in strange house and attract many attentions.
Cowardly foreigner.
Look, cousin. It's cardboard box. It's plain-looking cardboard box. Maybe we sneak around like, what is he named? The Solid of Snake?
The Solid snake of Snake.
Snake of Solid.
Snake of Solid. What else would a snake be exactly? Liquid?
It could be liquid.
A liquid snake? What a ridiculous idea. What kind of...
Well, could be worse. We could be Silly Gully Riding Man.
What?
Silly Gully Riding Man.
Wasn't he in Mortal Kombat?
No, not Mortal Kombat. Is other thing. Anyway, we digress. Let us get into box and sneak around and find Chancellor of Bears.
The box.
And what exactly was the purpose of that?
We are in box now. Box is safe. We sneak around in box. We find Chancellor of Bears. We put him under box. We sneak back out in box. Nobody notices a thing. If they see us, they just look at box and say, huh? What that noise? Oh, he's just a box.
You know what? You're a little bit more cunning than you look, dear boy.
Yes. Maybe if they have truck around and box have delivery location written on it, we get in box and go somewhere else as well. Is cunning escape plan. I not go to University of Gadgets and Engineering for nothing.
Snake, 忙しいところすまないが、ビッグニュースだ。
なんだ、また無茶を言うんじゃないだろうな。
Ask the Murloc.
ところで君は今どこにいるんだ。
Idiot cousin, was that you?
No, I think noise is coming from the tiny suspicious looking box we have inside our box.
I see. Well,
anyway, we must go find Chancellor of Bears before a small box is suspicious more.
Several hours later, our intrepid heroes and their small suspicious box arrived in the throne room of the Marquis de Salmon.
Halt!
Ah, cousin, we are spotted. Spotted, stop the box.
How could we possibly have been spotted? This disguise was foolproof.
Halt the box.
Salt.
Salt?
Halt.
Halt? Wait, why the Marquis of Salmon is yelling for sodium?
I am the Marquis de Salmon. I demand that you halt your box-like disguise immediately.
Okay. What was request of salt for?
I did not say salt. Your hearing is clearly flawed.
I thought I distinctly heard the word salt mentioned.
You will leave this place immediately.
No.
No? No?
No. We have come for Chancellor of Bears to find Cup of Moonsilver, to make money, to find out where noise comes from. And if you do not give us Chancellor of Bears, we have smaller box in here that may or may not contain tactical espionage action person.
Your overly complex quest will not win you any favors with me. If you seek the Chancellor of Bears, you will surely perish.
Okay, cousin, I have enough of this. Let us jump from box and kill the Marquis of Salmon.
Now you shall die.
Cousin, look. It's small waterfall feature with salmon jumping up.
Oh, that is the most pathetic thing I've ever seen. How did he get his voice that loud? Halt, I say, you shall perish at my hands.
It's funny. It looked like he's trying to get up river to mate, but there will never be river because it's just small waterfall feature.
Prepare to die.
I think no. Maybe we take him, cousin.
and maybe we slap people with him in the face. He could be funny.
Oh, yes, that would be quite comical, dear boy.
Yes, we sort of dance about
this. Silence! You!
Be quiet, silly salmon. You are not fooling anyone anymore. We will take you and possibly eat you, although maybe we will send you to laboratory for genetic harvesting for maybe salmon farming.
Prepare to fight!
Cousin, it's okay. I do this. I know how to do this. I know the etiquette. 3, 2, 1. Mortal Kombat!
Idiot cousin, stop eating the Marquis de Salmon and let's get out of here. Look, a large door. It says, Chancellor of Bears, do not open. Just get the door open, for God's sake.
Okay, I open the door. No need for door when we can break through wall.
No, don't break through the... Oh, God, it's not as cuddly as we thought. Quick, we'd better run away.
Run away, run away,
run away. Run away.
Quick. Into box with tactical espionage action man.
That's not going to work this time.
Oh.
Morlock Combat!
Last time on Ask the Morlock.
And so, our heroes were last seen running for their lives, pursued by a creature that could only be described as the Chancellor of Bears. And a very small box with legs. Having engaged the Marquis de Salmon in mortal combat and emerging triumphant, our heroic duo was surprised to find that the Chancellor of Bears was in fact a large, ferocious, and ravenous bear. We join our heroes hiding in a tree, hoping to escape from the paws of said carnivore.
Cousin, why are we in tree?
Well, if you remember correctly, you bashed down or broke through a door, or perhaps, no, it was a wall, wasn't it? You broke through the wall of the prison of the Chancellor of Bears. And unsurprisingly enough, the Chancellor of Bears was in fact a bear who was incredibly hungry, decided to try and eat us. We escaped from the castle, pursued by a small box with legs, which I'm still not entirely sure where that came from, a large ravenous bear. We got on the flying machine and crashed into the nearest tree.
Oh, okay. So, why is flying machine in many different parts around tree?
Because, dear boy, you never took flying lessons.
Oh, okay. Well, in that case, then, we need to fix the flying machine. Because if flying machine is broken, then we cannot get anywhere far, and you have no legs. How are we going to get place when you have no legs?
Well, dear boy, since you're the one with the legs, and I seem to be lacking the legs, I'm afraid you will have to be the party mule for the rest of the trip.
Okay. But remember, when we kill dragon and I eat inside and we get gold from inside the dragon, all the gold will be mine then.
No, I'm afraid it never works like that. You see, I have enabled Master Looter.
Oh.
Now, the flying machine, yes. Sorry, but by the looks of it, you do clearly not have the technical skills to fix this contraption. And besides, half of it appears to be on fire due to your incompetence.
Okay, we must go, like, fix it in, gnomes in Ironforge, you think?
Oh, God, I hate gnomes. Little scampering bastards with pink hair ring. Give me some gold. Would you like to join my guild? And eating your knees. Ugh.
Not all gnomes disgusting. Is bad. Yeah. Some gnome is good, like little female pinky-haired gnome with Xenrock and Pauldrons of Might. They look sexy.
You, sir, are a very strange man.
Anyway, we find mage for portal. Hey, look, there is mage over there on ground. Hey, what is that noise?
What is what noise?
That noise. I hear noise.
Noise?
Let us look round corner. Oh, he's just a box.
Ah, it's fine.
Let us go talk to mage.
Okay, to the mage. Hang on. How am I supposed to get out of this tree?
I carry you. I suppose I must carry you.
After last time's attempt to travel, I really don't trust you, but it's not like I have a choice. Right. I have a better idea. I'm going to push you out of the tree now.
Ah!
Right, and now I shall jump out of the tree and land on your soft carcass. Here we go.
Ow!
See? Now that wasn't so hard, was it?
Cousin, I am liking you less in the moment.
Oh,
but
dear,
look,
dear.
Here is mage.
Yes, let's go and speak to this friendly and no doubt incredibly generous mage.
Hello?
Sir, your arm appears to be sort of dangling at an angle.
Oh, it's you, the Murlocs. Don't you know who I am? It's me, the great Ronaldo.
Oh, God, not you again. Cousin, excuse me for a moment.
Actually, I wanted to thank you. It's the best thing you've ever done to me. Give me a whole new outlook on life, this.
Yes.
Being dead and all.
Yes, very nice.
Anyway, what can I do for you, gentlemen?
We, great, well, not so great, the rotting Ronaldo, we require a portal to the land of Ironforge.
Oh, I suppose I can do that. You might have to hold my arm up, though. It tends to fall off.
I am not touching that.
But, cousin, you must hold arm up because you have no legs.
Oh, God, hand me the stick.
Oh, come on, it's not hard, really. Just hold it there. Ah, there we go. You had one portal to Ironforge. There we go.
So, you sure this is a portal to Ironforge, eh?
Yeah, this is a portal to Ironforge. Or as near as I can get.
Well, since we only massacred and killed you and brought you back as an undead servant of death, I can imagine we can trust you, absolutely.
It's fine, cousin. Jump into portal. Away!
Bye-bye. Take care. Good luck, you bastards.
Now, my geography and my sociology was never particularly good. However, this does not look like a mountain.
Well, this is definitely a city. It have cobbled streets, many busty women holding cells out on corner.
Yes, but they're all above 4 feet tall. This is Stormwind!
Well, it's near to Ironforge anyway.
Why did we trust the undead Ronaldo? I mean, why did you bully me into this? No.
Well, you
taking advantage
need,
of the disabled.
We
like
must
that.
Find another mage. Excuse me, you mage over there. You with epics.
Yes.
You make us portal to Ironforge, please.
I have the power to portal you to Ironforge. However, I demand a portal rune.
Okay, let me find rune. Rune is on floor, see? Look, here is rune.
That, dear sir, is not a rune. That is, in fact, a rock which you have scraped some kind of smiley face into.
Look, you silly epic mages. You selfish epic mages. I know your type. You always have rune in pocket, but you say bring new rune. Bring 20 silver. You silly mages in all country. We beg for mages to come with water and like make crops grow when ground is hard and unfertile. But all mages with epics just sit in Ironforge on epic ram from Alterac Valley, which is round corner from our house anyway, but is beside point. And they sit in Ironforge, and they only make portal to Darnassus for stupid people, and they go to Molten Core and the Blackwing Lair because they are epic mages and all want epics, and nobody care about helping this small Murloc. So fie on you!
Okay, well, that was rather disturbing. I don't like you very much, so, well, bye.
Cousin, you find mage. I cannot do this.
Oh, God. You are the most uncouth excuse for a Murloc I've ever seen. Excuse me. Dear sir, that looks like a mage. Mages have sort of demonic pets, don't they?
Why, hello there.
Yes, you appear to be a mage.
Yes, I'm a mage of sorts.
Okay. What kind of mage, exactly?
A perfectly normal mage.
I see, with the horns and the devil.
Oh, don't be put off by this. This is just some sort of stylish, fashionable fad.
I see, that makes perfect sense. We require a portal to Ironforge.
Okay, I'll just contact my colleague in Ironforge. Right, Impsy? Yes, he says that he will portal you to Ironforge. All you have to do is join a party with him, and it'll all be okay. So, just do that now, and it'll all be fine, and nothing bad will happen. Nothing bad is going to happen to you at all.
I see. Well, that should be absolutely fine, then. I have absolutely no reason to distrust you. I mean, it's not like we've ever been deceived before today.
Cousin, he is rubbing hands together and cackling maniacally.
It's fine. That's just the infusion of arcane energy. It's sort of a par of the course for this kind of thing.
Okay. Okay, then. I feel I am being portaled to Ironforge. Away! I'm falling!
Yeah.
What is this? This plagued land!
Cousin, I'm drowning! I cannot swim!
Your incompetence knows
In
no
old country, water is all frozen! We all ice skate, but no swimming! Help!
Oh, why have the gods forsaken me?
Last time on Ask the Moloch.
And so, the last time we saw our intrepid heroes, they were drowning in the Cairdoa Lake. After accepting a portal from a particularly evil warlock, and still finding themselves without their flying machine, the Moloch's quest cannot continue. So perhaps they will find their answers in a rather sinister-looking village, on an island conveniently located close by. Or perhaps they will die in fire.
Oh, God. This is the last time I ever listen to you on anything.
Help! I cannot swim! Cousin, save me!
Oh, Lord. What kind of a Murloc can't even swim? I have no legs and
it's
I'm still adept.
There's no water in old country. Only icy depth. Icy ice.
Oh, God. Right. Okay. Hang on. Why am I attempting to save you anyway?
Because I have the legs. Help!
Okay, good point. Right, okay. Grab onto my arm, you blithering fool.
Okay,
right. How exactly is this going to work? I have no legs.
Do something. Blow. Oh, use power of hot air to get to shore.
That. Oh, God, this is not going to work. It's ridiculous.
Use arms. I will grab leg stump. Use arms.
Oh, God, this
is
so humiliating.
Water is getting in my eyes. It is stinging.
Stinging? Oh, God.
It's a plagued land.
Several hours later, our more than capable heroes arrived on the coast of a very mysterious island.
You, leg boy, on your feet, you weakling.
Slash flop.
Oh, God, I've met hardier bowls of jelly in my time.
Well, where are you, cousin? Building have many turrets.
Many?
Look funny. Look copyright infringing school type building.
The last time we came across a building with turrets, it was filled with giant bears.
There is sign. Bogwarts School of Scholomancy.
I'm sure I've heard that name before.
Scholomancy is,
It's a dance.
Is it dance?
It is a school of dance, yes.
Let us go inside. Maybe someone can portal to Ironforge. We need to get to Ironforge.
But it's a school of dance. How could they possibly help us?
Well, maybe dance can open portal in strange and mysterious way. Dance is all powerful.
Oh, dear. The plot holes abound.
We must go to Ironforge and get flying machine fixed so we can go and look for cup of moon silver and then find out where sound come from. Maybe in this Scholomancy building they have sound and we can follow. Because I not hear sound for many episodes now. Trail get cold.
It's more than likely that just doesn't like your face.
Eh? I was not listening. I was looking at pretty sign and admiring students.
I see.
School uniform look good.
Oh, God. Let us just enter this building before we are arrested.
Well, door is locked. Have you got key, cousin?
Let me check. No, I do not have the key.
Okay. Step back!
Oh.
Soviet cousin, handle this.
And you know what? Funnily enough, they didn't seem to like that.
What is this? What is this, cousin? His scholomance is full of dead things. This is no school of dance. Look, they pirouette. School of necromantic ballet this be.
Well, it did say Disco was dead.
He's not dead. Disco is undergoing underground stage. We'll have resurgence later. But this is necromantic ballet. Worst form of dance ever! Reanimating dead so they can ballet? Nutcracker by dead people!
Well, funnily enough, this may in fact be the place we need to go to find one of those portals. I mean, these people obviously wield phenomenal cosmic power in an itty-bitty living space.
I portal made by ballet.
Yet you...
Portal made by breakdancing, no. Maybe, but portal made by ballet, no. We must see headmaster and change school for the better.
May I remind you that you're the one who suggested we trust the evil warlock?
Be quiet. I no suggest that. Evil warlock, he tricked me. He say portal is safe. I assume portal is safe. I am trusting country boy. Nobody lie in the old country. In old country, if you lie, people chop head off. Anyway, we must find... You're a student. Who is teacher here we can talk to?
Why, hello, I am Barry Trotter, walking copyright infringement expert, and who are you?
I am the cousin Soviet Murloc, and this is the Murloc. He have no legs. We are looking for portal to Iron Forge with medium of ballet to make portal.
Well, I'm sure I can help you out there. I suggest you go and speak to Professor Rattlegore, our home economics teacher. He has many, many portal abilities. Yeah.
How we know what this Professor Rattlegore look like? Is he stand out from normal person?
Yes, he is quite unique. He has a strange hat.
Strange hat?
Indeed.
He have any other identifying features? Maybe big scythe-like claws, lack of skin, I don't know, glowing eyes, a big teeth, tendency to flay alive.
You're so incredibly gleeful, sir. No, go and see the home economics teacher. I'm sure he will sort out your needs. Yes, sort out your needs. I must get back to existing inside a children's novel.
Okay, we see you later, Mr. Barry Trotter. Watch out for the Reco Falmoy. I hear he
what?
Is bad. Reco Falmoy is in House Slytherin.
Oh, God.
Let us go, cousin. We will see Professor Rattlegore.
Oh, why are you trusting this person? I mean, he's...
Because he's student. Students don't know anything other than what they teach. They're lazy. They spend all day sleeping through to 12 p.m.
Okay. Against my better judgment. Basically, because I can't be bothered. Carry me forward.
Okay, I carry you very well. We see Professor Rattlegore now.
Several minutes later, our intrepid heroes arrived at the classroom of Professor Rattlegore, who was seen chopping cucumbers for a salad.
Excuse me, are you Professor Rattlegore?
Welcome to Rattlegore's Bar and Grill. May I take your order?
I was under the impression Scholomancy's School of Ballet. We need a portal to Ironforge via Powers of Ballet so we can fix flying machine and get on with rest of Epic Quest. Many episodes to come.
I can portal you with the power of quiche.
Power of quiche? Nobody likes quiche. Quiche is for silly people. You not portal us with quiche, you portal us with power of steak.
No, I do not do steak. Steak is far too popular. I like quiche. Quiche is good. Quiche.
Excuse me, I cannot help but notice you is wearing a pair of roller skates.
Quiche?
What? Oh, okay. Maybe you know somebody that can portal us to Ironforge with power of sensible ability. Like maybe, I don't know, pirouetting or Nutcracker or... what is other famous ballet? I don't know. Maybe power of tap dancing.
I'm not interested in your strange dance. I like quiche and derivatives of quiche. I like to bake things which nobody likes. You should go speak to Raz Frost Whisper.
Okay, you are scaring me with sound of voice now. We will speak to this Frost Whisper person. You know where we can find?
In the quiche.
In the quiche. Okay, maybe we will skip the quiche this time, and we will look for a room called quiche, because maybe I think you are quite silly, and we will go and speak to this Frost Whisper. Quiche is now scaring me on many, many, many different levels. Away, cousin!
I say, did you know that you would look exceptionally good in a quiche?
No. Run away, cousin! Run away!
Run away! Run away from the crazy
run
quiche,
away
man.
From the skinless, scythe-armed, bone-constructing quiche fanatic!
Next time on
Ask the Moloch.
I am sober again.
Quiche.
Last time on Ask the Moloch.
And so, the last time we saw our heroes, they were fleeing, uncharacteristically, from a quiche-obsessed Professor Rattlegore. Now lost in the long, gloomy halls of Barry Trotter's Scholomance of Wizarding and Necromantic Ballet, they search for Raz Frostwhisper, who they are told may have the power to portal through the medium of ballet, an ancient and powerful technique shrouded in mystery.
Where are we, cousin? What is this? The corridor is strange. Look, I swear, look, we passed that suit of armor 3 times now.
No, we didn't, you idiot. Of course, if you were cultured and knew what you were talking about, you'd realize that is in fact a 4th century piece of Chinese leather bracer, whereas the other one over there was clearly an 18th century Gothic masterpiece.
Oh, yeah, look, read inscription. Inscription say, Ni Hao.
Ni Hao?
Ni Hao.
Oh, dear.
Oh, this must be old Chinese farmer dynasty.
Ah, yes.
Anyway.
That is quite scary. Stop that. Stop it immediately.
It's not my fault.
Yes, it is.
It's not my fault.
Look at you. You're covered in grime and sweat, and you look like you're out of breath. Good Lord, you are so unfit.
We are looking for the Raz Frost Whisper.
Yes.
So maybe it's behind door number one.
Door number one?
Door have the big number one on it.
Interesting.
Look,
how convenient.
Number two, number three, or numbers up to 6.
Interesting. That will be ideal.
Look through door number one.
Let us open door number one, because of course there'll be nothing bad behind that like the last time!
It's a deal or no deal.
I see.
It's on door!
Oh. Okay.
Okay, calm down. Right, okay, roll call. Melissa Blackheart?
Yes, Mr. Ravinian.
Evilus Nomus?
Here, Mr. Ravinian.
Death to all those who play Force Metalus. Men! Okay, the rest of you appear to be here. Right, it's dodgeball. It's dodgeball today. And you should know, the first 3 rules of dodgeball are dip, dodge, and ducks. Yes, ducks. If you can dodge a limb, you can dodge a ball. Now, what the hell are you doing in here, Murlocs? Get out! You're looking for Raz Frostwhisper down the hall. Interrupting, like, physical education lessons. Yeah. Damn it, no respect for authority these days.
Oh, there's no in there. Maybe we go in door number 2.
No, good God, no. Oh, the undead sports lesson already has me cowering in black terror. Oh, jeez.
Okay,
why? Why are we even here?
Look, we're here to get portal to Ironford to fix flying machine so we can go find source of sound. And the cup of moon silver.
Yes.
Everybody know that. We keep telling everybody every week we're doing that. But look, it's a big door at end of hall. And if we go through a big door, maybe strange quiche man will lose interest and run away.
Yes, I think that may in fact be wise. Onward towards the big door.
Or I could break through wall again.
No, we've angered quite enough people with unfathomable cosmic power for one day. Thank you very much.
Oh, okay.
Yes. Onward! Carry me! Carry me now!
Okay, I carry you, but only because you have no legs and flying machine is broken.
It wouldn't be much use indoors anyway.
Maybe I throw you to end up home.
Maybe you would like to perish in the most excruciating fashion imaginable.
No, it's why I leave you here.
No, don't do that. That's very rude.
Off I go, end of door.
Hey! Back here now, peasant.
Will you say sorry? Apologize to cousin, or maybe I tell grandmother.
Okay, I am... No, I can't do it. I just can't.
Okay, you stay here then.
No, come back. Oh, God. I'm...
You can do better than that.
No, my God, I'm exploding.
It was more of strangled gargling sound.
What is
wrong?
It
was more of aggro cry.
And what is wrong with the sacred aggro cry? Do you disrespect your cultural heritage, boy?
No. We invent the cultural heritage. You disrespect by living in the big house.
Don't be
and
ridiculous.
Sharing.
Ridiculous. Oh, God. I cannot
Look,
for this argument.
We are at door now. We are going through door. You will shut up.
How did we get to the door in the first place?
Because walking and talking at the same time.
But I can't... quick, they may not notice. They may not notice. Let's get on anyway. Yes, we're at the door. It's very, very good, yes.
We could also take plot hole that has just opened next to us.
No, last time we took a plot hole, it took us 2 weeks to climb out of it. Let's not do that again.
Okay, through the door we go.
Full of mice. Okay, we appear to have entered the room of an enormously powerful lich, and you still think that this is a good idea.
Look, he's his lich. He's going to teleport us with power of ballet. And maybe breakdancing if asked nicely.
Why would he teleport us? The guy, I mean, look at him. He's 12 foot tall. He's enveiled in an aura of pure death and evil. It looks like he could, quite frankly, destroy us with a click of that bony little excusable finger he has.
Well, look, he looks sad. Why is he sad? Why are you sad? Oh, look, he's holding sign up.
Sign?
He say, I am death.
Death? He's deaf.
He's deaf.
Excellent. I can insult him. That will be fantastic.
He's not nice.
I don't care if it's nice. I'm the Murloc.
You
care enough
quiet.
For niceties.
Look. Over there on floor is bit of cardboard and pen. We will write message.
Oh, how convenient.
It's not convenient. We need the portal Iron Forge.
No, God, please do not attempt. Look at it.
We need
Iron
Forge.
No, look, don't show him that.
He holds up sign.
You know what? You see what the sign says? It says, why have you drawn a donkey? You can't write. You're illiterate. You're from the country of common peasants and mud-dwelling scum. Look at it. It's a donkey.
He's not donkey.
It's a donkey.
He's not donkey. It's
look.
Horse.
Oh,
and next to it is I. And then is crane, river, more horse.
Sorry, but Murloc hieroglyphics are not suitable for this kind of cultural affair. Give me the sign.
All right, you draw this silly sign.
Okay, right. Here we go. Excuse me, dear sir, who is all-powerful and could easily crush us with a point of
There's
his
no
body.
There's no room on sign for all
Yes, crack. There most certainly is. I mean, writing incredibly small. Here we go. There's meh. Yes, please portal us to Iron Forge now, KK, thanks, bye. Hold it up now.
Okay, he have other sign, it say, you must do interpretive dance for me.
What exactly is that?
I don't know. What is it? Oh, he have other sign. It say, interpretive dance mean you recreate event of past with dancing.
Oh, God.
He must he say, I guess what is, if correct, I give you portal, he'd say.
Oh, God. Okay, do you have any kind of memory of something involving dance? I mean, we could do something involving dancing, that would be easy.
I hear of good musical we can replace, have very good song, and it is all about dots.
Okay, what kind of musical?
It's called, You Get Minus DKP50.
Ah, the famous cultural icon. Excellent.
I remember how it goes. Everybody stand close together, then they fly into whelps, and then man scream very loud, and then all is die. And there is big symbolic dragon flying around. It represents Yorkov people.
Okay, listen the F up.
I will be dragon cousin, you can be raid.
Okay, I shall be the raid.
I am the dragon.
I am the raid.
Breathe, breathe, hit, hit.
Oh no, get away from the center.
You have no dots on me. I will deep breath, for you have no dots.
Get away.
I am being got down as fast as possible.
More dots.
No,
more dots now.
Is not enough. I deeper breathe.
More dots. Only the dots can save us.
Okay, you, Lee, you is close to my head. I knock you into whelps.
Lee, you fool, get away from the head. Lee, why are you still close to the head?
Hey, look, I am breathing. All move to center. No, stand away from each other. I fly around some more and I breathe.
Kevan suu oli vehnä, sellä koimme, se tonne toivotti. Pää oli märkänä jokaisella ja viulu se vonku ja voivotti. Ei tätä poikoo märkyys haittaa, sillä kaskoo lähiästä laitaa. Salivili hipput, tupivili tapput, äppyt, tipput hiljalleen.
Okay, listen up, boys. Whatever you do, you must not stand in the vicinity of other people.
I breathe.
No, if you stand in the right place, there is no way that you will enter the cave of the whelps.
I knock you into whelps because I can, because I am in Barebus. Fly, 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 fly.
Now, you must handle it.
Fly, you cannot handle it.
Go away. Breathe. Go away, Anixia.
Breathe.
Bad dragon.
Bleh.
Now, you must handle it.
Cousin, look, he hold up sign that say enough, too many 50 DKP minus reference. You got Ironforge. Hooray, portal. Look, what is that? He's not quite ballet, he's not quite breakdance. He's doing strange dance.
Perhaps it is polka.
Maybe. Oh, portal. There is a portal opening. Quick, we must jump through before it closes.
Kevan suu oli vehnä, sellä koimme, se tonne toivotti. Pää oli märkänä jokaisella ja viulu se vonku ja voivotti. Ei tätä poikoo märkyys haittaa, sillä kaskoo lähiästä laitaa. Salivili hipput, tupivili tapput, äppyt, tipput hiljalleen.
Last time on Ask the Mulk.
1-2-2-2. And so, our heroes were last seen disappearing into the portal of Ras Frostwhisper, the wielder of the might of interpretive dance. Unfortunately, something went wrong, and the Mulks were stuck in a void for 3 weeks. When they emerged, many things had changed. Unfortunately, this did not include the Soviet Murloc's underwear.
Why is this happening again? Oh, he's no soft like Lake.
Ah, all the pain and suffering.
Where, is this Ironforge? He's looking, red and sassy.
Yeah, it appears to be made of iron. There are many forges around. It would be reasonable to assume
Look! Small, stumpy men with a big beard. His Iron Forge is full of dwarves!
Oh, dear.
Look!
I like dwarves.
What is that? It's horrible and ugly. He has no beard. He has strange bump on chest. He's small like dwarf, but have strange bump on chest and no beard.
Oh, dear, yes. It's a gnoll, I believe.
He's Hogger?
Hogger? Yes.
Run away, Hogger is here.
No, we must not associate with Hogger. He is a silly man. Yeah.
He fenced the counterfeit goods.
Anyway, let's avoid Hogger. We need to find the repairs for your stupid flying machine.
Well, look, the big sign is, say, Tinkertown, 200 meter left. We got Tinkertown.
Okay.
See Gnome King.
Gnome King?
Yes.
I don't like the idea of this Gnome King. Gnomes should never be in any kind of position of power in this place.
Maybe we speak to his right-hand man, Mr. Rockfist.
Let us just go to Tinkertown before this gets horribly unpleasant.
Okie day.
Several hours later, due to the Soviet Murloc's terrible navigational abilities, our heroes arrived in Tinkertown.
You know what? I really, really do not like the look of this place. There's somewhat.
But look, look,
evil.
There is gnome with spinny shield standing on hill, and there is a bigger dwarf next to him wearing a Darth Vader suit, maybe his paladin set.
Really?
That must be Mr. Rockfist.
I don't...
Anyway, there is gnome with spanner. He can fix our flying machine. Everybody know that spanner fix everything.
Dear, I shall talk to this gnome, although I do not like the look of his mustache, or in fact the cut of his jib. Right, okay, I'll speak to the gnome.
Hello there, I'm the evil gnome with the spanner.
Hi. It seems to be rather odd to me that you simply admitted that freely.
Well, we're all evil, don't you know? With our tools and mechanicals, and we make doomsday devices at the behest of the Gnome King. Death to all the non-dwarven races.
I see. So do you have any expertise in the art of poorly constructed flying machines?
Oh, yes. Let me see what you... Oh, that's the Model 5. I designed that years ago. I can fix that. Would you like some machine guns on it?
No, I don't think that will be necessary. We're not particularly violent. Well, I don't like to use firearms. They are for the weak, as you should well be aware.
Well, very well. I can fix that. I'll just add an extendable claw and an interdimensional teleporting device, should you ever
need one. No, that is not necessary. Besides, I doubt we have that much money. No.
It's all free. No, you only pay once with gnomes. We've got the best warranty system since Alienware.
Alienware, you say?
Yes, Alienware. We have better after-customer support than Alienware do. They only repair things for up to 5 years. We repair them for life.
You see, I cannot possibly trust... Well, let me put it this way.
Would you like air conditioning?
No! No air conditioning, is it? No, it's irrelevant, dear. Look, I do not trust you. Let's face it, your facial hair is bizarre. No one of your stature could possibly support such a hideous mustache.
It's for balance. If
balance.
I didn't have a beard this size, I'd fall over from leaning backwards to look up at everything.
Oh, dear God.
So you don't want any extras then? No extendable claws, no machine guns, no interdimensional teleporter. You're the worst customers I've ever had.
Cease! Cease this evil immediately!
Oh, it's Spanx! What are you doing here, Spanx?
I know exactly what you're trying to do to these harmless, poor, innocent bystanders!
What?
I know of your evil scheme! Here, I cast entangling roots! Come, Morlocks, escape from the evil presence of this man!
Oh, okay, we go with you. You seem like a well-balanced person.
Wait, what are you doing following him? Since when could gnomes use entangling roots? What the hell is going on?
Come back here, you ungrateful curs! I haven't fixed your machine yet!
Escape from him! He is Satan incarnate on this earth!
Well, I don't know who to trust. We trust new person, because he knew. And look, he wearing what looked to be shrubs on shoulders.
Oh,
and,
Lord, you have the attention span of a goldfish.
Ooh, butterfly.
Okay, right, I want an explanation right now. Who are you, sir? What are you doing here? And why do you appear to have the power of entangling roots?
I don't know! You see, I am Spanx! Spanx the gnome druid!
He's a gnome druid now? How come gnome be gnome druid?
Well, I needed something to do between the arcane power and the trinkets and the horrible fiery death, so I learned to be a druid!
Oh, okay. This making sense is a good story. Continue.
You see, I had a rather life-changing experience a few months ago.
Ah, yes, I have many life-changing experiences. Every time I see little plastic bag flying up, I think how it mean that it's all okay and that there is one big design for us and that medicine know all.
How on earth do you continue to exist, dear boy, is quite beyond me.
Silence! You must listen to my story!
Okay, continue your story, we is listening. You was fishing.
No, I was not fishing! I was,
You was drinking.
No, I do not drink! I am Presbyterian.
You was, You is in battlegrounds and you activate arcane power and trinket and you go pyroblast. Boom!
No, I did that last week. I was abducted.
Cousin, what does abducted mean?
Abducted, yes. To be abducted, one must be taken because you are a blithering fool. However, in this case, I believe our dear friend is probably lying.
No, I'm not lying. Don't be ridiculous. But I was abducted by things with tendrils coming out of their faces. Tentacles. Evil, evil things.
You was abducted by Great Cthulhu?
No, it was not Cthulhu.
Hooray, it's Cthulhu.
Silence, you idiot.
No, it was not Cthulhu. It was Draenei.
Draenei is a fairy tale. Nobody believe in Draenei anymore. You may as well believe in Protoss or Zerg or Terrans if you believe in Draenei.
I can hear them. They speak to me. They're coming.
Oh, don't be ridiculous, you silly blithering gnome. Absolutely nobody believes in... What is that green light?
Well, hey, look. Is things underneath it is moving upwards at a very slow rate and then accelerating rapidly.
I see.
These defy all laws of movement and physics.
Generally
speaking... Gravity go down, up.
This is not a good thing. Really, this is not a good thing.
Oh. Light is passing over us.
Dear God! Where in the blue hell are we?
What is this? These look futuristic and vaguely sci-fi.
Who is the man with the bald head?
Would you mind identifying what you are?
I'll be asking the questions if you don't mind, dear sir. Who are you with the tentacles coming out of your chin?
He's quiet, cousin. It's Murlocs. He is from the Middle Lands, and I am from the Winterspring.
Are you able to cease thinking on command?
You is very rude, Mr. Funny. He's a green color Draenei and look very different from the others. Is you even real Draenei?
Sir, obviously the captain of this vessel. Who are you?
This is Captain Jean-Luc Picard of the USS Enterprise.
Oh, he's Picard. You think he maybe make it so?
I very much doubt it at this point.
Get off my bridge!
You over there, you with forehead funny thing. You look very merry today.
Sir, I protest. I am not a merry man. Get off my bridge.
Hey, cousin, look. I am sensing disturbance in the forest. Something big coming. Very big. And red. And piratey. Blood elf space pirates!
Red alert! All hands to battle savings!
So, Captain Picard, we meet again.
Yes.
The circle is now complete. Before you, I was but the learner, but now I am the master.
You do realize that you can never hope to win.
Why is that?
Because you are just a paladin. I am a shaman. We are inherently better at PvP.
I do not believe the propaganda.
Very well. Strike me down and I shall become more Imba than you can possibly imagine.
Oh, really? All too easy.
So, friends, I'm Frost Shark!
Last time on Ask the Murloc.
And so, our heroes were last seen on the bridge of the USS Draenei, as Darth Belfius and Captain Jean-Luc Picard continued their epic duel. As the interdimensional spaceship crumbled around them, the Murlocs cowered under a console. We join our heroes in the cowering. Yeah.
Cousin, it's time to go. Stop watching funny duel between Belf and Shami Paladin Blue.
No, but it's fun. Look, they're carving chunks out of each other with blades of light.
No, ship is falling to pieces. We must escape. Find Pod and...
The ship isn't falling to pieces. The
cousin,
ship is fine.
Cousin.
Oh, it's in my bag.
Cousin, look at me. I wave my hand. We must escape now.
Sorry, your tricks only work on the weak-minded, dear boy.
Hey, look, a Twinkie.
Ah!
We must escape now.
We must escape now.
Follow your cousin, the Soviet Murloc, to safety.
I will follow my cousin, the Soviet Murloc, to safety.
Okay, we go.
Okay, we go.
Stop doing that.
Stop doing that.
He's really annoying.
It's really annoying.
Who is that?
I have no idea. What are you talking about? Why am I even here?
It's this funny woman with bun hair.
Funny woman with bun hair? Hair of buns?
Hair of buns. It's looking like a pastry of some sort. Maybe Danish.
I see. An illegal Danish? Oh, dear.
Oh, he's thinking same thing. It's no good. Either I get smarter or you get stupider.
I think it's more like a slightly illicit Danish at this point.
Okay. Hello there, Mrs. What is your name?
Why, hello there, strange fishy people. My name is Princess Lema. You must deliver this message to me. Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi. Right, I've got this disc. I'm just going to put it in you.
What is it doing? Is it my mouth? It's not for this.
Oh, please, continue. This is hilarious.
I am not a trash can or can-shaped robot. Go away, you silly woman.
It's the only use he has. Continue. Keep shoving it in there.
But you must save me from the evil Lord Belfius. Or he will do horrible things with his Star of Death. Or David, possibly.
Sorry, but I think the words care and face spring to mind at this point, dear woman.
I say we eat her head.
I say that is a very good idea at this point.
Murlocs away!
Several minutes later, Princess Lema was dead on the floor, with no hair. The Murlocs were in fact quite sated at this point, and continued along the corridor of the collapsing starship.
Cousin, why is I feel very ill now. Why is the corridor spinning on side and is all upside down now? And why am I defy the gravity? Oh, this is very, very strange.
Dear boy, you are floating with the power of your own hot air and stupidity. It's very unpleasant. It's a cultural phenomenon.
Oh, okay. So is now time to burst into song?
No, I don't think bursting into song is the best idea at this point. Let's look at the situation we're in. We're on a starship in the middle of space. Last time I checked, I could not survive in a zero-oxygen environment. Is this all... I blame you entirely for this.
Oh, okay. Let's find the escape pod. Where is Mr. Merry Wharfman? He maybe know where the escape pod is.
Quite frankly, I don't think he liked us. He was not a merry chappy last time we spoke to him.
Okay, we will find the escape pod... Hey, look, there is.
Well, that was a little bit more easy than I expected.
It's very convenient. I sensing some sort of big showdown is coming.
It is quite possible at this point. However, I can't imagine who would want a showdown with us. I mean, we're merely here searching for some silly sound and cup of moon silver and all this kind of rubbish. It makes no sense in a plot scenario.
I don't know. Maybe we have some more Murloc combat.
No, Murloc combat has been done to death.
Or maybe Chancellor of Bears has caught up with us.
I don't think the Chancellor of Bears can in fact exist in a zero-gravity environment.
But we was brought here with the beam of light. Maybe Bear was brought here with beam of light.
But we lost the Bear hours ago.
Okay. In that case, we just get in the escape pod and blast off!
We could just get in the escape pod and blast off, couldn't we?
We could.
Yes.
Hello, Toe Jam and Earl.
What?
Oh, it's Toe Jam and Earl.
Why are Toe Jam and Earl here on the interdimensional spaceship?
I don't know, it's plot hole.
Indeed. Let's just get on the escape pod and have done with it.
Okay, there is many buttons here. Which one I press?
Let's avoid the red one. We all know the red one is bad, MK.
Okay, there. What about this one with the plastic case over? It's a... eject?
Eject? Sounds like the common language for silliness.
I don't know. Maybe not press that one for now. How about to press this big green one here?
A big green button? You see, that's always helpful. We like green buttons. Green buttons are usually a sign of very good things.
Beep. I pressed the button.
It didn't do anything.
Oh, okay.
You did it wrong, you incompetent fool.
Oh, maybe I should not say the beep then. Maybe I should just press the button instead of saying the beep.
Explosions are generally not a good thing. At this very moment, the Murlocs are spiraling towards a distant planet.
This is all your fault, you incompetent excuse for moron.
It's not my fault. It's all the Princess Lemur's fault.
I blame you. You took me on this ridiculous quest in the first place. Find the sound.
We have tape. Let us see what is on. How we view tape?
I have a very good idea. Give me the tape.
Okay.
Okay. And open your mouth.
Huh?
Now insert it into your mouth like this.
Oh.
Okay. Right, now give me that flipper of yours. Now, this looks like an electrical plug socket. Now, we put it in the plug socket immediately. Oh, how incredibly delightful and pleasing. It's projecting through your eyes. Now stop blithering and let me watch the movie.
Gentlemen! You must fly beyond the big gun and then make our way to the city where we will assault the macro.
It appears that someone has sort of taped over this. What is that anyway? It's some kind of crazy sitcom or sci-fi.
Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi! Help me! Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi! Help me!
He's just looping now.
No, stop talking. I'm trying to listen to the message.
Okay.
Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi! Help me!
Macron!
I think you appear to be stuck. I'll slap you on the back of the head and see if that gets you to work.
Ow! It's finished now. Take my hand out of this socket, please.
No, I think I'll just leave it in there as punishment for your crimes. Now, why did you even give us this tape? It serves no practical purpose.
Well, I think we should listen to the first part and go past the bigger gun and then assault Macron.
Assaulting the Macron sounds incredibly dangerous and unnecessary, don't you think?
Well, maybe if we store up enough core damage and invincibilities, we can do it.
Yes, now, I'm just going to sit over here, away from your smelly carcass, and look out the window to see a rapidly approaching planetary surface!
It's not all planetary. Look, it's bits and pieces. It's not all together.
Oh, God, I hope we don't miss them.
Well, look, maybe it's Outland.
What is the Outland?
I don't know. I hear about it when I'm small. Everybody say orcs come from Outland. Evil big smelly orcs come from big smelly Outland, but it falls to pieces because they no pay the rent.
Dear Lord, everyone knows the orcs are brought by the storks. Why do you think I called orcs in the first place?
Okay.
If you say so.
I have my hand in socket, but I disagree.
Dear.
Anyways, we're approaching very... look, there is Big Gun. Yeah. For future reference, anyway. We are approaching very quickly. We must brace for impact. So please, can you take my hand out of plug socket?
No, that is not entirely necessary.
Okay, I will just assume position then. Yep.
Did you have to make that noise while assuming position?
Yes.
The wreckage of the Draenei escape pod lay smoldering on the surface of the Outland, until a small noise from inside the craft beckoned the return of our somewhat battered and bruised heroes.
I think my leg is broken.
Oh, well, join the club, dear boy. Mine is too.
You don't have legs.
Be quiet. I want sympathy.
Oh, okay. Anyways, what is this? There's a strange blue man with a big axe.
A strange blue man with a big axe? How do, sir?
Hello!
To be continued. As the Murlocs is an improvised radio play and a WoW Radio production for Epic, airing on Saturdays at 7 PM GMT or 2 PM Eastern Standard Time at http://www.wcradio.com.